Welcome back, guys. This is Unfinished. I am your host, SK Gitonga. Do not forget to follow me or us on all social media platforms. Today, we're talking about matatu etiquette, which takes us to our that question. Do you prefer matatus with music or without music? Let me know what you think in the comment section.
I love music, personally. But then I school loud. So, utapata kuna ingine ni very loud. Mpaka ukiingia pale, unachoka times two. Ya vile ulikuwa umechoka ukiingia. Sometimes inakuwa too loud kwa masikio, inakuwa uncomfortable. Alafu tena the type of music wameweka unapata ni ikona too much bass. So, inakuwa uncomfortable ukiwa pale ndani. But in a music that is good and volume iko regulated vizuri, it is nice. Sometimes inakuwa poa, inakukam. Yeah, it's all about the volume wenye wameweka.
It depends. At times someone just wants quietness. But with music it's better, just soft music. Because if I'm trying to counter that point of people, because at times when it's quiet, you find those who are phone calls, they're the ones who are making the loudest noise. But now when there is soft music at the background, someone can pick at least a phone call, maybe if it's urgent, try to respond to that. Yeah, so for me when it has music, a softer one, or maybe a radio, you see, yeah, that's a good one.
I prefer without music. Juu kunaweza kwa matatu alafu like kuna msanda wako kupigia, so uwezi kupigia juu ya the loud music. Sasa uwezi conversate na mse kwa on a call, so I think isiwekwe.
Naweza prefer wale ambao wako na mziki, lakini iwekwe katika kiwango cha wastani, isiwe ile ambayo ni loud, na kwa sababu saa ingine wako na mziki mzuri lakini vile wanaiweka inakusumbua, labda mtu amechoka, ametoka kazini, hataki kelele. Kwa hivyo ingekuwa bora iwapo wangekuwa na wanaiweka katika range ambayo ni average, sikuwe loud.
I prefer with music because at least inakuentertain. Alafu pia una feel uko comfortable kwa gari. Unajua saa ka gari na move. Saa umeboeka tu hapo unasikia tu kelele ya dinga, hiyo ileti shangwe.
Na prefer matatu iko na music kwa sababu hiyo ndio like wenye wasee kidai kutulia tu. Labda kuna wasee wengine wako mavitu, so nyote mnataka tu mkuwe tu mna feel vibes zenye mnadai. Yeah, but lakini music si ya kila mtu.
It will depend. Sometimes I prefer with music, soft music, especially in the morning. But unapata during the daytime there's a lot of unaka volume kubwa and the bass. Unapata when you're in a matatu na there's that bass, it affect even health wise, unaona. So sometimes it's uncomfortable, sometimes it's comfortable, so I just prefer soft music zenye hazina bass mingi,
maybe slow music, you know. But then most matatus na kuanga gengeto, you know, those loud music, rock and all that stuff. So I don't prefer matatu with music. I just prefer either slow music, I'm a tukwetu just quiet. Because I'm more of an introverted person and I love quiet places. So I prefer matatu without music.
I can say both are good, but then if a matatu has music, then it has to be moderate. Not that you put the boombox speakers until your eardrums are gonna burst, but also it shouldn't be too quiet. Just some soft background music is good. But I know the young folks, I'm young myself, but not so young. So when I was a teenager, I always wanted to be in that loud matatu. But you see, not all of us are teenagers right now. And so, depending on the audience, the music should be moderated. Again, the music should also not give us videos which have pornographic content. You know, young kids are watching and so on. So the content should be fine. And the content should be moderated. But again, that music has given the oomph to the matatu industry in Kenya, because people as far as America come here to just see how is the matatu industry. But then we should not celebrate vulgar language and vulgar music in our matatus.
I prefer with the music. Unajua kwa nini? Music inatoanga mtu, kuna tuseme for example kama stress, kama kuna stress hivyo. Yeah, inatoa. Alafu gari, hiyo gari lazima gari kama hizi mat size na pasa kwa zote tu dego zote tu zijazo juu wewe inatoanga tu inekanga tu mtu morali hivyo, unaona, morali inakuwa tu sawa kwa hiyo ngoma. Hey, unasikia tu ngoma Hii ni miziki ya pale, inachuna vifine pale.
Naweza sema ziko na ngoma, lakini siku ile loud sana. Azinana uwezi onge na simu. Ikuwe, yes, kwa na ngoma, but isikuwe ribu masikio. Ama totally ikuwe ina ngoma. Juu ya healthy yako ya masikio and all that.
Can't say I like matatus without, but I prefer matatus without. You get many times ukipata a matatu with music, your music iko juu. I mean, unatoka kwa gari and you're like, am I really hearing? But unapata kuna gari kidogo sana, unaweza ingia, there is music, but volume ni kidogo, ni mzuri tu kwa everyone. So it is also better gari kutokuwa na music. Because iko tu sawa na kila mtu.
Matatus with music, of course, because I love music. It's one of the things that makes me relax. So maybe after a busy day in school, you know, maybe oftenly I prefer matatus with music. Yeah.
Okay, it depends, because you know now youths love matatus that have music. But now older people love matatus that are silent. Now it depends, because also for the matatus, for them to put music, they're attracting the younger people. So that is a trend for the young. But now the older people need silent matatus. So it depends with where the matatus are operating.
I don't have a very discreet answer for that. I'd say sometimes music is good, yes, but the level, like maybe soft music, not extremely loud, because sometimes for silent matatus, you feel maybe bumps on the road or something and you just want to have a calming experience. So music is good, but the level of sound should be like maybe soft music, yeah.
Personally, as a person who loves and does music, I prefer matatus with music, because I don't know if it's just me or sometimes when I get out and you're probably just in a low mood, ama bado komo singizi and all that, but kuna that music that you listen to and you're actually hyped up for your day and you're ready to just do your daily thing. I also feel like it's a very good way of embracing and also advertising Kenyan music, because some of the music that I do hear for the first time inakwanga kwa matatu. So yes, I do prefer matatus with music, because zenye hazina, I just find them boring, and I also do not want to listen to my neighbors' conversations. So absolutely. Which takes us to our last question. What are some of the things that you feel should be changed about matatus? Let me know what you think in the comment section.
Ni the way they drive. Some are so reckless kwa barabara. Kwa sababu maybe yako in a hurry to make some more cash. So I think it should lazima ikuwe regulated vile wanaendesha. But sometimes some people just get away with it. And we have seen a lot of accidents because of that carelessness. Another thing, maybe etiquette, pale kwa mats. Hawa watu wenye wana nini, show some etiquette. Mtu anakuja hapo na stress zako na wewe unakuwa rude kwake. I've seen some people wameongeleshwa rude kwa matatu, wengine wanakuwa mistreated.
It depends. Yeah, it depends. At times someone just wants quietness. But with music it's better, just soft music, because if I'm trying to counter that point of people, because at times when it's quiet, you find those who are phone calls, they're the ones who are making the loudest noise. But now when there is soft music at the background, someone can pick at least a phone call, maybe if it's urgent, try to respond to that. Yeah, so for me, when it has music, a softer one, or maybe a radio, you see, yeah, that's a good one.
Ni kitu kwanza kama means of payment, unapata like kuna matatu zenye zikubalingi mpesa, ama like unakuja unapata kama ni wanasema mpesa, kama ni mpesa lazima kuja kizunguka akiangalia conversation message ya confirm kama umelipa. So as in kama wangeka a better way, like a till, though kuna some matatu zenye zinakuanga nazo, ingekuwa far better.
kuwa na bei ambayo iko imesawazishwa. Kuna hii tabia ambayo wako nayo wakati ambapo hakuna watu wengi, bei inashukishwa, alafu wakati labda kuna mvua ama labda ni wakati wa sana sana wakati wa mvua ama kukiwa na crisis na kuna magari mingi, bei inaweza ikapandishwa hata maradufu. Kwa hivyo nafikiri hiyo ingekuwa bora iwapo hilo lingebadilishwa. Pili, kuwa na magari ya kutosha kwa wakati fulani, kwa sababu kuna wakati unapata kwamba kuna watu wengi mahali fulani wanangojea magari kwa wakati mmoja, na kuna katika ule upande mwingine hakuna watu wanaoingia wanaoabiri magari, na hili sana sana linafanyika wakati wa asubuhi na jioni. Nafikiri ingewapo wangeweza kufanya mikakati ya kuhakikisha kuwa magari yanakuwa pale ambapo yanahitajika, ingekuwa bora. Na pia kufanya magari hayo yawe yanaweza tumika na watu walio na ulemavu. Nafikiri kuna katika nchi hii inasemekana being poor in Kenya is a crime. Kwa hivyo utapata wale watu ambao wana ulemavu na inabidi watumie magari ya umma, wanasumbuka sana kwa sababu hazina accessibility. Kwa hivyo kama industry, hiyo ni kitu moja labda wanaweza wakaangalia ili Wakenya wote waweze kuyatumia kwa usawa na kwa urahisi.
We introduce vitu kama PS, alafu soft drinks hivi, alafu pia nimeona wamekezi electric bus. Sasa wazifanye classic ikuwe comfortable yani zaidi, hiyo ita attract more passengers.
Kwanza makarao waachange tu kusumbuana nasi, alafu promote my event kama Nganya Awards yenye inakuja December.
Wapunguze speed because a lot of there have been accidents actually, so you get the drivers driving while drunk, so maybe that causing accidents on the roads. So I prefer them to stop over speeding.
Music you to travel to tuko tumenyamaza. I prefer that. So wakitokea tu matatus without music, then personally I'll appreciate.
Okay, what can change maybe is the way the decor of the matatu, the interior and the exterior, the way some matatus are designed. Of course there are some, because they take the art graphic so far, even you see an element of evil, satanist kind of graphics. So they even glorify the devil in the graphics. So they should understand that as much as the matatu does not belong to the passengers, but it's because of the passengers that it's there. So you shouldn't have an element of, you know, glorifying violence through those graphics or glorifying some satanist tendencies. Because you can clearly see some kind of graphics which are done in some matatus, and sometimes they say things are spiritual. Sometimes that is why maybe accidents occur. So you see, you either be neutral in your graphics or just be liberal, but then don't go extreme in either way. Because even the society as we live in, it is always good when the society is balanced.
Tuseme ni route ya kwanza venye kama Isili inapaswa kuwekwa the same type of, kama ni Madri ipigwe tu kala moja, ipigwe tu kinganya hapo fulani moja tu the same. Kama ni Karen hivyo, kama Super Metro venye unaonanga venye imepigwa hivyo ki the same company hivyo. I mean nge prefer kama hiyo tupige tu the same color ya nganya hivyo, afu zote ziko tu fiti pale kama Ngoma, kila kitu go the same.
The music and hawa si wengi wanaitisha pesa na shindwa. Okay, like last week nilingia kwa matatu nyona wanakongomeka paybill hapo juu pochi lipa na pochi. So mimi nikaingia tu, napenda kufanya vitu mbio mbio, nikawa nimeondokea tu sisumbuana. So nikalipa, na kama naniambia hukufaa kulipa kwa hiyo pochi, ungengoja nikuambie. Like wakwe tu clean, kama ni hiyo pochi waiweke pale mbele, ama kama si yenyewe inatumika ondoa kabisa.
Wanafaa waeke sheria. I mean, kuna matatu mzee sana, it says. Alafu, there's a certain route I use. Ile space ya viti mbili, wamezi force zikakuwa tatu. Na nyi watu lazima msukumane, mtoshe hapo.
I just think it's the, you know, the discipline in the roads. There's nothing else bad with matatus like this.
The moral of the content that they put in the matatus, one, yes, it's good to have a music in the matatus and everything, but what content are you displaying? Is it helping? Is it, do people learn from whatever you're displaying in your screen? Yes, you want to attract the young people, but attract them with positive things.
All matatus should really look up to Super Metro, because for me, that experience, that is it. Like, it's clean, customer service is okay. Time, they actually keep time for you, because they don't make unnecessary stops and all that. So if there's something that Matatu Industries will do, it's just look up to Super Metro.
Some of the things that I feel should be changed about Matatus to make them more convenient. First of all, I'm gonna go with speeding. I feel like working in Nairobi on a daily basis is a matter of life and death. You're always fighting for your life. From like a passenger's, not passenger's, but a pedestrian's perspective, you're always fighting for your life. I feel like there should be rules that govern how they actually drive the cars. Second thing is the conductors should have like a certain uniform, because sometimes the person who actually invites you to the car is not the same person who's asking for the money, and they always have different terms of payment. And lastly, I feel like VTs in a park washer. I understand they probably don't ever have time, but probably doing that once in a week would be a very good thing, because sometimes when I know nakalia kiti and you start sneezing all of a sudden, like, there's a lot that goes on with those seats. So they should be clean, and the windows and everything. So generally just cleaning less and maintenance. We have come to the end of the show. Thank you for watching. I am your host, SK Gitonga. Bye.